Let's start with a red-hot renewable, solar power. Just as plants convert sunlight into energy to grow, sunlight can also be converted into electricity. Instead of using a generator to produce the power, special converters called photovoltaic cells change the sun's raw energy into usable electricity. Companies like Thin Film Technologies in Iowa are on the cutting edge of solar cell manufacturing, making them more power efficient and more cost-effective. Company founder Frank Jeffrey slowed down long enough to talk about some of the cool ways their cells can be used.
There's an expedition going up Mount Everest that has some of our modules on mounted on a tent for power, and it's mostly for charging the battery packs for video units that are going up an expedition. So there are a lot of portable type applications. Long term, what we are shooting for is what we call the building integrated market, where the photocells are mounted into the building panels themselves.
Mike Kappas runs a music agency in San Francisco. His panels aren't mounted in the roof, but on the roof.
We've got 96 panels here. This is actually, when it was installed at least last year, it was the largest solar installation in San Francisco. It provides all of our energy needs and then some during the day. We don't have storage for electricity here. We don't have batteries that we charge up, so we do draw off the grid during the night. But the net result is that overall we are generating more electricity over the course of a year than we're using. So we're actually supplying a surplus back into the grid for California.
Which is why, if you look closely, you'll see their meter is actually running backwards. Ask Kappas why solar, and you'll get a passionate pitch for this renewable.
Well, somebody asked me about why did you go with solar? And I think the question is, why would you not go with solar? Solar energy is created during the daytime only, but that's the greatest time of need for electricity. So you're creating the electricity at the time it's most needed, so we can avoid the production of power plants. We can avoid drilling oil in Alaska or off our coastline, knowing that you can create your own energy with no pollution whatsoever. For an indefinite period of time, you continue to produce and produce and produce electricity with no harmful effect to the environment. I wanted to do that.
While sunlight itself is free, there is a cost associated with solar power. Purchasing the PV cell systems can be quite expensive, especially on a scale large enough to produce significant amounts of electricity. Design improvements and increased manufacturing could bring those costs down. Currently, solar power accounts for less than 1% of all the electricity generated in the United States, a number Jeffrey, Kappas, and many others hope will increase. Should the sun get a starring role in our energy future?